Namaste all of you. Welcome to RSV Group of Schools YouTube channel. Today, I am going to discuss our grammar topic, subject, verb, agreement. Agreement, the word shows a relation between two things and two objects. So here we are going to discuss an agreement between subject and verb. Usually we know that we take a singular verb for the singular subject and plural verb for the plural subject. So here also we are going to discuss about the subjects and the verb singular and plural. So first I'll tell you what is subject verb agreement. Okay, it means that the person and number of the subject of a clause determine the person and number of the verb it will take. Again I'm repeating, it means that the person and number of the subject of a clause determine the person and number of the verb it will take. So it is very important to know that if the subject is singular and the plural, it means we came to know whether the subject is singular and the plural, only then we can take the correct verb with that particular subject. So there are some terms and conditions where we use singular and plural verbs. First, and usually makes a subject plural. It means and is the conjunction here. You can see and is the conjunction here, and I am saying to you that usually makes a subject plural. How it makes a subject plural? If we join two singular subject with the conjunction and. Okay, if we join two singular subjects with the conjunction and, then it will take a plural verb. Ram and Shyam. Ram is a singular subject and Shyam is also a singular subject. But if I am using Ram and Shyam, it means I am connecting both Ram and Shyam with the conjunction and, then I use Ram and Shyam are going to school. Understood? R is the plural verb, so we use R here. Next is games and sports and name of the countries, they always take plural verb. I am giving an example to you that India have won the match. India have won the match. Here India, a name of a country, and I am using the word have, that is plural. So it is clear to you. The next, capital city and seat of political power. See students, I am saying that country name takes a plural verb. But if the name is a capital city and seat of political power, then it will take a singular verb. Okay. I am going to give an example that the assembly is going to announce a bill in the next session. So assembly is going to announce. Okay. Next, news is always considered as singular. News. S is there. Sometimes student get confused that ma'am S is there, that's why it will be plural. But no, it is always takes a singular. It is always considered as singular. I'm giving an example that this news is very bad. Hana? This news is misleading. So just like that, we use a singular verb for the news. Now next, certain diseases. Suppose measles. So measles. R is wrong. Measles is. So we also use singular verb for the certain diseases. Okay. Now let us discuss how we have to find out whether the subject is singular and plural. Sometimes we confused. So we just take this example. How to achieve? It means find the subject regarding singular and plural. Is it singular? Okay. Yes, it is singular. It means if the subject is singular, then how we came to know is the subject I. Okay. If the subject is I, then we always use a singular verb, am, do, was, have, etc. Next, if the subject is you, then we always use the verb plural, are, etc. Next, he, she, it, this, that. So we take singular subject, it, was, etc. So this is the formula of finding the subject Okay, next, if the subject is not singular, it means if it is plural, then use a plural verb such as are, do, we, were, etc. Again, I'm repeating, how we have to find out whether the subject is singular or the plural, then first, if it is singular, then we should be very, So, I'm going to repeat how we have to find the subject, whether the subject is singular or it is plural. So, we have, so for achieving the subject, first we have to decide it is singular. If the subject is singular, then first we have to check, is the subject I? If the subject is I, then we have to take a singular verb like am, do, was, have, etc. And if the subject is you, okay, if the subject is you, then we have to take plural verb, you are, okay. And if the subject is he, she, it, this, that, then again we have to take singular subject. This is a ball, that is a ball, just like that, okay. Now, if the subject is plural, it means if it is not singular, then we always take a plural verb, such as are, do, were, etc. I'm repeating again, if the subject is plural, then we have to take a plural verb such as are, do, were, etc. So these are some rules to find the subject. Now, one more thing that I want to discuss with you, that if two components are thought of together, okay, if two components are not mentioned in the subject, but if they are thought together, then also we use the plural verb. We use scissors, trousers, socks, shoes, etc. So these are some rules to find out the subject and to take a verb according to the subject. So this is our topic, subject verb agreement. Thank you.